At the moment, we still return some text here. And now it's time to use this particular property that is passed to this large text component. And now, instead of some text here, we will use JavaScript syntax, pair of curly braces like that, and here will be any JavaScript expression, and let's type here text like that. We will use this variable. And now I see here some other text. That's how we could use properties inside of the large text component. Now let me get rid of this console.log statement like that. And also, let's try to adjust attribute that is passed to large text component here inside of the app component. And if I modify it here, let's add one more exclamation mark, immediately I see changes here. Because now this large text component returns different JSX depending on the properties that are passed to this component. And that's what we see here. Now I could very easily reuse this large text component several times and pass different text to it as JSX attributes. Let me show you how to do that. Let's go to app.js file, copy this line from here, paste it here underneath this line, and now adjust this text. Other text. And now I see some other text that is generated by this large text component. And other text that is returned back by this component. And that's beauty of components. You could create component only once and reuse it multiple times. And look and feel of every instance of the component will be different. That's what we see here. You could reuse React components as many times as you want and pass different attributes. And in this way, you actually modify props inside of the component, like we did here in the large text component. Great, that's our props, and the main outcome is that you could modify props by passing different attributes in the JSX text, like we did here. You could pass multiple props if you want to do so and if you need multiple props. And also, React component is re-rendered anytime when one of the properties is changed. That's our React props, and that's how you could modify React props from the parent component, because app is parent component relative to large text component that is now child component of the app component. Alright, let's get rid of those two lines like that, and let's proceed, and next let's talk about React state.